Greetings, this is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight once again. My talk today focuses on the fact that it was announced yesterday, which is August the 9th, that Tesla is now applying in both California and Nevada to be allowed to do truck ballooning, platooning. And so our talk today kind of focuses on what this is and what the implications are of this. Bonjour, Vigate, Strasvice, Ni Hao Ma. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. I was intrigued because Reuters is announcing that Tesla has been applying to get permission to start experimenting with truck ballooning, platooning, when it comes to autonomous trucks in both Nevada and in California. There are other entities, universities, etc., that have been running experiments with this platooning, and it would seem logical, given the relationship between Tesla and both states, that they would consider allowing Tesla to engage in this activity. So what truck platooning is, if you don't know, it's when you have more than one truck. In this case, Tesla has requested permission to have two trucks in a platoon. And basically, the lead truck would have a driver, and the truck behind will be without a driver. So in which case, the software that's running between the two trucks would allow the trucks to run pretty much at the same speeds, etc. Platooning is also interesting because, unlike double or triple trailers, you can have some separation where vehicles can get between the two trucks and the trucks can still communicate with each other. So the impact on traffic is helped in that process. You know, three other points about platooning. Number one is that one of the big reasons you want to platoon trucks is that you save 20% on fuel for the trucks that are in the rear primarily. So, you know, that's a pretty big savings. Another is that you can get the benefit of, you have that tractor already on that truck, so when you get to a location, if you're picking up drivers to go from there, both tractor and trailer are already ready to go, and the lead truck can leave the other trucks with drivers immediately and move on. Another aspect of this is that one of the biggest challenges you're having in trucking, at least in the United States, is wide open spaces where most drivers want to be within 24 hours or within a day's drive of home. And so by running platooning until you get there, you now have the potential of those folks having shorter driving routes that they have to do that allow them to get home. And the platoon can go on the longer routes that would take people away from home for multiple days. My initial reaction to platooning was it sounded like a bad idea because you already have double and triple trailers, so why bother with platooning? And it turns out that the platooning solution is attractive because, you know, what if you go to 3, 4, 5 vehicles? Now you're talking the savings of a driver in each vehicle, and you get the fuel savings, and you can still move the freight. So it becomes excellent, a just-in-time, you know, railroad. I was kind of also fascinated by Tesla's entry into this because I felt as though there was enough problems dealing with just getting into, you know, the 500-mile distance on trucks with the new battery and the new truck, and that would be challenging enough. But, to their credit, Tesla has decided to show their value proposition more readily across more areas. So they're bringing their autonomous driving expertise from cars over to trucks faster. And I have to say that I kind of like the whole platooning idea, because there's been one of the things I kept thinking about is having 80,000-pound trucks going down freeways with crazy drivers you know, interrupting the driving process of that truck and potentially generating giant accidents sounded extremely dangerous to me. So I think the platooning idea is a good one. I have not read or seen a lot of platooning occurring in the United States, but at least with diesel trucks, we've seen platooning executions going on in Europe. And I'm attaching a Mercedes, you know, the front photo that I have is of a group of Mercedes in a platoon situation, and I'm including some cards above this video to include some of the platooning tests that are being done by Mercedes in Europe. The next aspect of this that I found kind of interesting that Tesla potentially has an edge on is the fact that, given that Tesla will be the only player in the long-distance trucking run at a battery, I think it'd be really fascinating to see the lead truck be electric and the trucks behind being diesel. One, because it's, you know, there just aren't enough batteries right now to get the whole thing to be electric. It'll be that in the future. But Tesla can show more value to customers than just the fact that it's an electric vehicle. They can show the value of the fact that they can now partner with diesel vehicles to cut the fuel consumption of those diesel vehicles while being led by electric. So I think the penetration impact on a fleet for Tesla would immediately be greater because you could sort of blend diesel and electric, and I think that's a really attractive solution. Moving on from this, I just think that, you know, any business, when you look at cost, 60% of your cost in a business is labor. So as soon as you're able to reduce the number of drivers relative to freight being shipped, I think you're in a better condition. Actually, looking forward to comments from some of the experts on my page, because I have to admit, when I first looked at the situation, I was wondering why anybody would want to do platooning, because you can immediately just do double or triple trailers and there's no need for platooning. But all these questions start to arise, like, well, what if you ended up being allowed to platoon and that worked well and you can now platoon double and triple trailer tractors over, you know, no turn, very little traffic areas? I think it becomes very interesting because you're lowering costs based on number of drivers, you're lowering costs based on number of trailers that are in motion at the same time. So there are a whole bunch of interesting possibilities that open up from the platooning solution. So in general, I think that I'd have to put myself in as a fan of the test of the platooning with electric vehicles in the lead. Obviously, it'd be a lot better to have electric everywhere and still have, you know, the reduction. But I have to admit, I think it's pretty bold of Tesla to move well beyond just to figure out if they can get into the long-distance business and simply start moving up the food chain to more aggressive solutions when it comes to the introduction of the 2170 long distance version of trucking. The other thing that came to mind, frankly, is that as we've discussed previously, there's an interesting phenomenon going on, which is, how is the relationship between Tesla and Mercedes going to work out when we get to big trucks? Because Mercedes has already received and been testing diesel-based Peloton or platooning trucks in competitions in Europe, in the Netherlands, etc. And so I'm wondering about whether or not, you know, if they remain partners and haven't become enemies, Tesla can skip out on a huge amount of work and possibly have the platooning concept on the roads and being used faster because they get to leverage the relationship with Mercedes that they have, and the fact that Mercedes and some other manufacturers already have solutions in operations in Europe that they could piggyback on to start generating data, getting implementations, and providing solutions to customers that have less time before they arrive to market. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Your viewership and viewing of the ads helps us cover the time costs and other costs of production. Much appreciated for your sticking around to the end. Tschüss, mach's gut, au revoir, à tout à l'heure. Please like and subscribe and have a great day. Look forward to our next conversation and appreciate your comments. Thanks.